Hello, it's Keith here, and welcome to the first of the simple series of 650 to assembly programming tutorials. Now, this series is slightly different to the platform specifics. We, in this series, make a single assembly file for each tutorial. This file is pretty much self-contained, and sometimes there's some bitmap data that's separate, but basically it does a single task. And the idea is that you can get started with this really easily on a new system. And if you don't want to use my tutorials, you don't need to rely on all the include files that make up the platform specific series. So hopefully it's a bit easier to get you started doing really simple things that you could use as the template for your own game or program. So today we're going to be doing bitmap drawing on the BBC. So all we're going to do is we're going to learn how to create a simple bitmap on the screen, and we'll be able to use that if we want to make a simple game later on. Okay, well, let's go over to the code and let's have a look at it and let's see today's example running. So here's the code for today. I'll just get back to the top of it here. And so if we run it, you can see we've got a little smiley face here. So this is the first example we're going to do. This is just an 8x8 sprite. Very simple, effectively just a basic tile kind of design. A lot of systems that use tile maps use an 8x8 graphic, so I thought it would be a nice, simple way for you to get started with a basic program. Anyway, that's the first example, and I'll just load up the second one. Now, obviously, an 8x8 sprite isn't too impressive, so we do have this alternative one. And this is our Chibico mascot, and it's a 48x48 pixel sprite that we're doing there. So, you know, an example doing a little bit more. So we'll start off with the simple 8x8 sprite, and we'll look at the code that does this. So the code that I'm using here does use various zero page entries. We're defining a set here, and we're using them in the same way as the Z80 would. So we've got HL for a source, DE for a destination, and BC for a byte count. Now, I know some people won't like that, but I was a Z80 programmer before a 6502 programmer, so that's the way I tend to think of things in my head. So it's what we're going to be working with today. Okay, so you can see here we've got a run location here, and that's our origin, and we'll see why we've got that in just a moment. Now, the first thing we're doing is we're turning off interrupts here, and then we are sending a command which is basically going to disable the sound. If we don't do this, the emulator will make a loud sound when the system starts up, which will be quite annoying. Okay, now there is a bit of a trick to what we're doing here. Now, the operating system of BASIC will be using the low areas of memory, and we're going to use the high areas of memory for our defined screen. The problem with that is that we will be using the same areas that are currently being used by our program code. So we're going to shift our program code to a much lower area of memory, and we're actually going to shift it all the way down to 200, effectively overwriting the operating system. So our program is currently really running at the 3000 range, but we want it to run at the 200 range. And so what we're doing here is we are running a copy command, copying all of the program code to that lower area, and then we're doing an absolute jump to this, which will be the new running location, which is defined by this hexadecimal 200 in this org statement here. Now, though, of course, it is a problem with this. We can't use any calls or absolute jumps here, so we can only use branches. And you can see here we're setting a carry for no reason other than so we can use this relative branch command rather than an absolute jump here. Now, if you don't understand that, don't worry about it. Just leave this code as is and it will work in this example, but I just needed to explain that's what's going on here. Okay. So we're now ready to start setting up our graphic screen. The graphic screen is defined by the ULA config and the CRTC config, and we'll see those in just a moment. You can see here we are writing the ULA bytes to FE21, and the CRTC we are selecting a register with FE00 and a new value with FE01. Now, if you want to see the settings we're using, they're all the way down here. So here's the CRTC config. This defines the shape of the screen and the memory address that's been used by the screen. And you can see here we're defining the memory address with these two bytes here. And we've got various other settings here that are just defining the shape of the screen. We're also defining the colours. Now, the way that the BBC works is we are mapping effectively sort of byte configurations to certain colours on the screen here. And so we're defining a certain nibble will have a certain colour option. And so basically, 4 bytes within the ULA config will be set to a constant color. If we don't set them all to the same color, then you will end up with an effect where you will get a kind of vertical striping effect because of the position of the nibbles will affect the resulting color. So these 4 here are for color 0. You can see they all end 7. These are for color 1. These are for color 2. and these are for color 3. And if we don't set those correctly, then we will not end up with the correct colors for our Chibico character here. So that's what we have to do there. You can see there's a quick guide to the colors there. So you can see color 7 here is the black for the background, for example. Okay, now that's how we are doing our definition of the screen here. So we're now at this point. So what we're going to do next is we're going to read in from a bitmap file, and we're going to select a screen location in memory, and then we're going to transfer the data to that screen location. Now here's our get screen position. The screen setup is a little bit weird on the BBC. So we're going to have to discuss that, I suppose. Now, the formula we have to use to work out our screen is as follows. Effectively, when we define graphics on the screen, the consecutive bytes in memory will go first down the screen for 8 lines and then jump back up and go down again another 8 lines. And this is done in bytes. So each byte within our 4-color screen here will contain 4 pixels. So our 8x8 graphic of the smiley will be made up of 2 vertical strips that are separate, and you can see them here. This here is effectively the left-hand side of the smiley face, and this is the right-hand side of the smiley face. And if you're wondering what this bit is here, well, this is the extra colour information because the smiley mouth were a different colour. So, as I say, this is the left-hand side, the first set of 8 bytes, and then the 9th byte will be written at the parallel to the first one, just here. Now, this is only works if we're on a character boundary, an 8x8 boundary. If we were 4 pixels down, this wouldn't work. But as I say, that's how the screen is physically laid out in RAM. And that's something we just have to work with, unfortunately. So how do we calculate a screen location? Well, if we're past an X and Y position and we're working with simple 8x8 boundaries, what we can do is we can multiply the X position by 8. And we do this by bit shifting here. We're shifting to the left repeatedly. Every time we shift a byte to the left, we're effectively doubling the value in it. We are having to just carry any overflow into the DE here. So A is effectively the low part and D is the high part. And then we transfer A into E here. So DE now contains the X position multiplied by 8. And then we are now having to work out the Y position. And we're having to do quite a lot of multiplication here to achieve that. Now, when we want to calculate the Y position, we're effectively having to multiply it by 640. The reason for this is that the screen is 80 bytes wide. And if you remember, we go down 8 lines for each of the 8 consecutive bytes. So to move down a Y strip, we have to multiply by 640, which in hexadecimal is 280. Now, what we're doing here is we're effectively doing bit shifts to effect that multiplication. We're ignoring the bottom 3 bits of the Y position because they will be quite tricky. Because as I say, the first 7 consecutive Y lines would actually be just neighboring bytes within the video memory. Now we could add those later, but of course this wouldn't work with this screen calculation routine because we're actually relying on being aligned to an 8x8 boundary with this example. So we're just ignoring those here. We're then multiplying that up, adding DE here. Once we've calculated that Y position here, effectively multiplied by 640 here by all of these rotations, with then adding the screen base. Now the screen base, as we've got it set up, is at memory address 4180 here. And so we're just adding that here. When we return here, we've effectively calculated in DE the screen position in memory for the XY position that was passed to this function. I know that's a pain, but this is enough for us to do the sort of Grime 6502 style program that we looked at once before. So as I say, this is enough to just get us started with some simple graphics. So we've got our screen position, we've got our bitmap here, and now we're able to actually draw our bitmap. So what we're doing here is we're selecting an X and Y position here. We're using getScreenPos, which will return in DE the destination of that position. Okay, so now what we need to do is we need to just get our bitmap into HL, and we need to transfer the number of lines, 8, multiplied by the width in bytes. Now, as I say, each byte is 4 pixels and our image is 8 pixels wide, so that's effectively 2 bytes. So 8 white lines times 2 bytes, and we're just repeatedly transferring the data to the screen, and that is what gets our little smiley to the screen. Let's fire this up. And there it is. So we've got our smiley. And if we change this to just a 1 and we run again, well, you can see we've only drawn half the smiley here. And that's because, as I say, we've done 8 consecutive bytes, but they are all on a single Y line. So there we go. So that's the simple example of the smiley. Now, this example is almost the same. Effectively, all of the code is identical. The only differences are we've now included a bitmap here, a file. Now, this is in the correct format for this system. Now, if you want to export a file for this example, you can do it with Myaku Sprite Editor. It's free and open source, and it's included in the Sources 7-zip download. If you go to here, BBC, Save All Bitmap, that will export in the format used today. This is what I used to create today's bitmap example file. Okay, so that's being included in just here. And you can see we're now using this as the source just here. We're using our same getScreenPos calculation before to get the memory address, but this time you can see the loop is much more complicated. Now this time our image is 48 pixels wide, and if we get our calculator up and we do 48 divided by 4, you'll see that that's effectively 12 bytes wide. Now, because the image, the Y lines are all consecutive for 8 lines, we're going to draw it in 8 pixel tall strips. So we're doing our 12 bytes wide times 8 pixels, 8 vertical pixel strips, and these we can just transfer as is. But then when we get to the bottom of that, we're going to have to move down a whole strip. And the way we do that is again to add hexadecimal 280, which is 640 in decimal. And that is the effective entire width of the screen times 8 lines. And that effectively moves us down one strip, and then we just repeat for the next strip. Now we are defining the image as 6 strips tall here in X here, and we're just counting down here until we've completed. Now if we just change this to 3, for example, just do that and run again. Well, you can see we've only drawn half of our Chibico, and if we change to 12, well, you can see now we've printed some garbage and we've probably gone off the bottom of the program code, because really that should probably be twice the size. But anyway, you can see how we can easily configure this to do different sizes of image. Of course, the only limitation with this version is we are rounding the Y position to a multiple of 8, because this code is only very simple with regards to the way it calculates the Y lines. So that's something you've just got to understand with this. If you wanted to write more advanced code, you could do so. However, it'd be more complex and probably quite a bit slower. Anyway, though, I thought this was a good example as a way to get started with a bit of BBC programming. So that's what we've got to look at today. We looked at Hello World last time, and also how to compile a file and run it on an emulator. So if you missed that and that's something you need some help with, please go back and take a look at that. If you want to leap ahead and learn more stuff about the BBC, please have a look at my platform specific series, because I've already covered a great number of tutorials on the system in that platform specific series. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed watching today. I hope you found something interesting and you're going to enjoy programming on the BBC. If you want to look at other systems, I've got a wide variety of Z80 and 68000 tutorials as well, so please take a look at my website and my YouTube channel, because I've got a playlist relating to many, many systems. Anyway, whatever you do, I hope you enjoy programming and I hope you enjoy the BBC. Thanks for watching today and goodbye.